Assalamu alaikum, good evening and welcome to this special program of British Bangladeshi Who's Who. My name is Zakir Khan and we're here to discuss this year's event, and I know many people watching this program are already very familiar with Who's Who and the publication. Now, last year we held the event in a very prestigious, very glamorous venue, the Meridian Grand, and we as a community felt absolutely welcomed there. And we're very privileged and very honoured to say that we're going back to the same venue this year, so you should come and join us. Now, without further ado, let me introduce you to my guest. Now, I'll start from my far right, Mr. Shahdat Karim. Assalamu alaikum. Now, as you all know, Shahdat is the founder and editor of the British Bangladeshi Who's Who publication. Shahdat, welcome to your show.
Thank you for having me.
It's your show. Thank you very much,
Shahdat. It's a community show.
Absolutely. Okay. Next to Shahdat, we have a young lady, Nikita Malchandani, who is the managing director of Meridian Grand. Nikita, welcome to your show.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here today.
It's our pleasure. Thank you. Now, on my far left, I have Mr. Muhammad Nurul Alam from Alam and Co. Accountant. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Mr. Alam, how are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
Thank you for coming to the show.
Yep, okay. Thank you.
And next to Mr. Alam, a very familiar face, a very popular individual from the British Bangladeshi community, someone I'm very proud of for his achievements. He is none other than Councillor Ms. Parvez Ahmed, who is the mayor, the Honourable Mayor of Brent Council. Parvez Bhai, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, and thank you very much to you, especially for inviting me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for coming, because I know you are so busy with your mayoral duties. You know, you have so many every day.
That's true.
So thank you for finding the time to join us.
Thank you.
I'll come to you in a second. Okay.
Thank you.
Shahdat, let me start with you, the founder, the editor of the British Bangladeshi Who's Who publication. Now, obviously from humble beginnings, now in its ninth publication, which means ninth year.
Yes.
Wow. Now, how does that make you feel? I mean, how do you feel? This is, you know, did you ever think it's going to be this successful?
Well, if I'm frank, I did think it would be this successful. The reason is because our community is a very resilient community. And if we take something as a community, we make it work. And that's why I had the confidence from the beginning. Because it's a community initiative, and with various people from various walks of life behind us, various well-wishers, supporters, I knew that this will go from strength to strength. And thankfully, that's what's happened. I mean, we're not anywhere near perfect yet, but as you said, from humble beginnings, we're still humble, but every year we...
It's always good to be humble, isn't it?
Of course it is. Yes.
Whatever you're doing.
Certainly, certainly.
Now, without giving anything away, you know, are we expecting anything special, anything, you know, for this year? For
every year, there is always a surprise. And as you said, without giving anything away, all I can say really is watch this space. You know, we are working with Meridian Grand. We had a very, very, very good and very decent program last year. So we always try and maximize the potential of the venue, maximize the presenters and the entertainment and so forth. So this year, again, we plan to do the same.
Thank you very much. Now, I'll come to you, Mr. Alam. I believe you were there last year.
Yes, it was my pleasure meeting.
Absolutely.
Now, last year,
how did you find the event?
The event was excellent, beautiful, and indescribable. That is why I was impressed this year in advance that I'll cooperate with you, and I wish them a good success. And even Shahdat has explained that more new presentation will be this year. I'm also expecting two, and I think this year will be more and far better than the previous year. Every year they are learning. This is the ninth occasion. And within these ninth occasions, without going too far, I feel there's a great success.
Fantastic.
Although that was my first year attending
your first year was my event,
and attending in the first event, I was very much impressed. I felt that our community, our people require this type of gathering, and the step they have taken that is welcomed by everybody, undoubtedly.
Thank you very much. Well said. I think that's the end of the show. He's covered everything.
He has, yes.
Great. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I come to you last, Mr. Mayor. Nikita.
Hi there.
Welcome to the show.
It's a pleasure to be here today.
Thank you. Now, Nikita, I have to, you know, again, tell you how wonderful your venue is. You know, I believe you were part of the whole setup, you know, from the beginning to, you know, to the end, in terms of the decoration, the layout, everything. Wow.
What we did from the start was we wanted to create a venue that was versatile for a number of purposes. Obviously, corporate events like the BB's Who Awards and weddings being our key focus. The venue has actually been built with the Bangladeshi community in mind, and it's no surprise that about 25 to 30% of our events are actually from the Bangladeshi mm-hmm. community. And it's our pleasure, therefore, to host such a prestigious event at the venue. I mean, the BB's Who's Who last year was our first year, mm-hmm. but I gotta say, it was just so impressive and so incredible. We really thought that the way the event celebrates people, not just from one sector, say restaurants and catering, but from a variety of sectors. I mean, I met a very interesting Bangladeshi author. I met politicians from the community, and I think it was just so fantastic to celebrate different people within the community who are making a difference.
Fantastic, yeah, and we look forward to coming there again this year.
It will be our pleasure.
Hopefully you're going to be there this year as well.
Of course I will be this year as
well. I'll come back to you in a second, Nikita. Now, Mr. Mayor. Now, I'm just want to follow on from what Nikita said. An atmosphere, an evening full of successful British Bangladeshi people from all walks of life, from barristers to accountants to TV presenters, business people. What a wonderful occasion. How do you see this?
I can tell you one thing, beginning of my start. Who is Who when since this was started about 8 years back? And from since that time, I was very much involved. I like it, their idea and their way. And since last 8 years' time, I believe, maybe I missed last year actually. I was in out of country, and another one I missed. Out of eight, six times I was attended. And I've one thing I can tell you exactly what Shadar says, and every year is something different. That's their try to mm-hmm. giving as a towards the community. And in terms of present venue, yes, last year I missed it. I believe this venue I heard is such a nice venue.
And yeah, have you never been?
I've been only once in the one wedding, but it's a wedding and this sort of
engagement
is yeah, really different, course, I believe. So I'm waiting to see this year, next month, to go myself and I'll see how it is going. And definitely, I believe, again, Shadow, then he said it will be different than other year.
Well, there you go, Nikita. You're going to have the mayor of Brent.
Fantastic. We're very excited to welcome you to the venue.
Thank you.
Okay, now, Shadow, let me come back to you. Now, I read one of your forewords in one of the publications that the one thing that you said that one of the challenges was to, you know, was finding new talents, and hidden talents or hidden gems. Is this still the case in terms of?
Look, the reality is that our community, day by day, is sprouting geniuses in all various walks of life. Now, it's very difficult for us to go out and search for these individuals if they don't put themselves forward.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
As you said, you know, it's always good to be humble, and our community, British Bangladeshis, are very modest and humble people. They often don't like self-publicity. Yeah. So one thing which I say every year when we come on these programs is that we need people to nominate individuals or to bring them to the forefront so that we can recognize their achievements. And it's not just to recognize their achievements for the sake of their own recognition, but also that they can have a platform and they can be positive role models for the future generations. So that's why, you know, we encourage people to every year to bring others forward so that we can showcase what they've done.
That's a very good point, Alam Shah. Then this publication, it's not about showing off. It's not about saying, look who I am, look what I've done. It's actually about celebrating success, achievements from the British Bangladeshi community. It's also about encouraging the younger generation to come forward, you know, to be part of this. Now, how do you see this? I mean, do you see this publication as a, you know, a reference point or a directory to British Bangladeshi success?
Like, it looks like the morning shows the day.
Morning shows the day. Right,
so
okay.
As long as you do your events and other things, publicity is also essential, which bring all informations and everything in one kite, one thread. And I agree with Sadat, it is not possible for us to search door to door, they bring the talents. Mm. One talent should nominate another talent, should introduce. That's the way we can grow up. And I can see even his father, So Goni Bhai is a good friend to me as well. So he worked hard to bring and introduce the people from our own community so that everybody can be introduced. This is very encouraging.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that reason, after attending in the events last year, I myself convinced that I should cooperate with them. And that is why I'm here.
That is why you're supporting this year.
That is why I'm supporting, and I'm here. And I've given, and I told them I'll continue supporting as long as I'm here.
Wow, thank you very much.
That's great news.
that's fantastic news. Now, Nikita, coming back to you. Now, moving on from what Shadow said, it's an event where we're trying to celebrate the achievements, the success of British Bangladeshi community. You know, we have people there, the senior generation, the younger generation. We have people from all various backgrounds, you know, politicians, professionals. Now, you know, you said that you really enjoyed the event last year. Now, is there anything you're expecting this year in terms of, you know, the attendance or the actual presentation?
I think that one of the things that really impressed me last year was there was a very strong, as a young female, as a young Asian female, I saw that there was a lot of young British Bangladeshi women involved in the event too. And that really inspired me as a young woman who started her own business, you know, obviously started her own venue. It was an inspiration to me to see other young women doing the same, pursuing different career paths. And I think that's a real strength of BB Who's Who. And so I do hope to see that featured again as well.
Fantastic. And the other thing I was going to ask you was the venue itself, you know, it's an amazing place. Last year, we had two different rooms. We had the holding area and we're in the main reception area. Did you actually go to the holding area? Did you see what was happening there?
I did go to the holding area. It was fantastic. So we had a whole drinks reception area. We had canapé space, which was fantastic. Traditionally, how we use the venue for weddings is actually slightly different, because obviously the area that we used for a reception, we use as a segregation for men and women for example, for a Bangladeshi wedding. So the venue is built with a number of purposes in mind, but certainly for segregation for men and women, if it's a wedding that is it requires
that. You thought of everything.
We've thought of that. We also have prayer rooms inside the venue. So again, these were useful last year. So if anybody needs to pray during the event, we have separate men and ladies prayer rooms within the venue as well.
Fantastic. Thank you very much.
I would like to add another thing as well, because just you mentioned about the book. So this book actually is like a reference for our community.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was very much happy myself when I've been about a couple of years back, I believe it was in the House of Commons. And suddenly one member of parliament, he bring one director, he said, look, you were in there.
I said, really?
I've been go through from being first page to last page, and such a great book they published, and it is really helpful for us to know your community.
Absolutely.
So these are a reference, a very great reference for us. In terms of success, if they want to success, then we as a community need to engage with them more closely, then we can do a lot better where they are. And this is our responsibility as well, not only them. They bring something for us, and our initiative, it will be plus point as well to get something better out of it.
Talking of success, I mean, you know, this is a prime example, this gentleman here, the first person of Bangladeshi origin to be the mayor of Brent. You know, that's a huge achievement. So we are proud of you. And I think, you know, this is how we should support one another. This is the way forward for our community. Now,
I have to add as well, quick one second.
Yes, sir,
as well. Just you mentioned about women and power. So look at that in Brent. This is not only myself. We have in Brent 3 member of parliament. So 2 female and 1 man. And out of 2 female, 1 is Bangladeshi as well, origin Bangladeshi British. So that is our great achievement in Brent as well. So I believe these are the way if we... I think I don't have any knowledge about, I think you have as well, Asagibai. We don't have any booklet like this from our community to show something. It's a presentation, it's a fantastic. If you give someone this present, then it's happily they will be take it.
Absolutely. I
never seen anyone.
I think if anyone questions us, says as a community, what have you achieved? We'll just say, well, there you go. There you go. This is what we've achieved as a community. And
yes.
I think it's a great reference point.
Yeah.
Now, Shadow, I remember last show, I don't want to name anyone, but
yeah.
Someone, one of our guests actually said that he got in a bit of trouble with the law. And when he went to court, he went to call, and he took this with him. And he said to the Lord, he said to the judge, Your Honor, look, I am actually a very prominent member of the community. I'm featured in this publication. And they said, oh, really? Okay, then we let you off. It's a true story. It's not made up. It's true. So, it's quite...
Yes,
yeah. Useful.
We try and help people in as many ways as
in
possible.
In many ways as possible.
No, that is true. That is true. That's really I appreciate about it, because like this booklet, I said it's a community involvement is very important. Just a lot of when I go through the booklet, when I receive the new edition, always I go through, and it's our duty to, improve or not improve actually. What I'm going to say to you about up to date. Mm. Where we was
up to date,
and where I am now. So it is our duty to up to date. It's not publication's duty as well, because our responsibility as well. Where am I? Where I was?
That's a very good point. I'm going to come to Shadotti on this point. This is a very valid point. So if I was in this publication from the inception, from beginning, throughout the years, I'm still in the publication. Mm. Do we actually ask for new?
Every year, we ask for renewed information.
Success,
And in fact, some individuals will feature in 1 year, and then by the following year they'll come out because they haven't done anything.
Right.
So you have to be active. If you're dormant, don't expect that you're in there for life. It's not like the House of Lords where you're a life peer.
That's great.
Every year you have to be active, and that's partly the reason why we work together with organisations like Channel S, who obviously are the TV channel in the Bangladeshi community. We want to work with the best and the biggest, and that's why we work with the likes of Channel S or Meridian Grand or other organizations who are the best or the brightest at what they're doing.
Absolutely. And I think here I just want to mention, Channel S is the media partner and has been. So thank you very much for all your support throughout the years. Now, Nikita, we are, as a community, obviously, as you can see, we like to celebrate. Mm-hmm. We like to... build on our success, mm-hmm. And we hope and we are very fortunate that we have people like yourselves who are there to support us. And we just want to say a big thank you to you, to your company, to your father, for hosting us last year. And we really look forward to coming again this year. In terms of the Who's Who publication, we feel that we can improve every year. We can bring new faces, new individuals. Now, is there a similar thing in the Asian community?
I think we have similar directories, but I think one of the most innovative things that Charlotte's done over here is actually create this into an event. And events naturally, especially today with social media, Twitter, Facebook, and how people use this, everything's in the moment. And to create an event out of it actually creates so much excitement that I think everyone tends to be talking about it a lot more. Mm-hmm. And I think, as you said as well, it's a constant striving. So anybody who has a business will know, I'm sure you'll know and I know, it's always about striving to be the best, achieve the best. We believe we're the best venue in London because we're constantly striving to outdo and look after our clients, look after our guests. And I think that's exactly what Who's Who does by giving people that motivation. Look, you can't just be in this for life. You have to strive. You have to challenge yourself to do things, to be in here. And I think that all that tends to do is to build and create a stronger community, because constantly everyone's striving and it snowballs and the effect is greater and greater as a whole for the community.
Do you know what? I think we found a new presenter.
but Nikita is quite right, because striving, and if you're self-competitive, as in you're competing with yourself, then every year you think, okay, last year I did this, but how do I do to stay in this publication or whatever,
That should be your aim to do something new every year, so you stay in the publication.
So next year I'll be in this chair.
I think you can come now, actually.
I'm joking.
Come on the break.
I would personally like to congratulate Sadat. In this age, he's a legal practitioner. Besides doing his own profession, he's doing and publishing his book. This is one of the best.
I think
it's not only for the Who's members, it's for the public
for the community.
Community.
I think it's unfair for me to to get all the credit for
it. Right?
No, you deserve it.
I'm a small puzzle piece in a massive puzzle. You know, we have a massive team. We have the whole community behind us. We have organizations like Channel S, like yourself, other, you know, various prominent members, you know, sort of teaming up together to make this successful. So
of course, we are not ignoring the other people who are supporting you.
Yes. No,
Channel S is a media partner, by your and at the same time, all of your associates who are helping, they also deserve this compliment.
Absolutely.
But on the top of that, a person has
someone needs to be driving seat.
Someone needs to be steering the wheel.
<That's right>. Yes.
I mean, and of course, Shadar's father.
Shadar's father, well, he's on the top because initially it was his idea to do something
for the community.
Community. And he's still continuing doing for the community.
And he was working with the community many, many years.
But you know, he's the one person I've found, I've come across, who works in media, but doesn't like to come on media.
That's right.
No, no. Exactly the same question I was asking him this midday. Will you be with us? He said, no, I'll watch you all. And I'll enjoy that.
So that's absolutely right, because I've seen, since I know him, just you mentioned about it, it's true, he was involved with the media, but he never, ever in the front line.
Thank you, Paras Bhai. I have to take a short break. Dear viewers, please join us after the break. Please grab yourself a tea, coffee, whatever else you drink during your break, and come and join us in a few minutes. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to this special program, Rish Bangladeshi Who's Who. I'm your host, Zakir Khan. I've now been joined by three new guests, three new prominent members of our community. And I'll start with my immediate right, the far right. I have Fahmina Chowdhury, who is the event manager for Meridian Grand. Welcome to your show, Fahmina.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome, and looking forward to it.
Yeah, well, I did come today for a bit of moral support and I've somehow ended up in front of the camera.
That's always the best, you know that. Always best. Right. Next to Fahmina, another very familiar face in our community, a very well-known businessman, Kamrumia. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you for the invite. For some reason, everyone gets my surname wrong. It's Ali, actually.
Kamri Ali.
That's it.
You know what? I've done it deliberately to see if you're awake.
Good.
You're awake, Kamri.
I am awake.
It's Kamri Ali. Right, Kamru, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Right. My immediate left, I have another very familiar face, a person who is, you know, a presenter himself on a television channel, none other than Farooq Mir MBE. Assalamu alaikum.
Welcome, Slam. Thank you for having us here.
No. You're welcome, Farooq. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you.
You're good. Thank you very much. Okay, and we still have with us Mr. Alam. Yeah. Thank you for staying on.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right, Farooq, let me start with you. British Bangladeshi Who's Who.
Okay.
Tell me.
I'll tell you a little bit about my involvement.
Absolutely.
And why I'm supporting this particular venture.
You could do it as a presenter, see? I don't even have to ask you a question. Carry on, Farooq.
As you and some of the guests here will be aware, or some of the viewers who you mentioned, I've had a program myself, so some people will be familiar. I was brought up in the north, in Leeds, where I'm from. And for me, it was really, really growing up in a place where we don't have as many Bangladeshis in, say, somewhere like in London or a place where I work in Town Hamlets, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really, really, what this is an opportunity to highlight not only people who are doing very well in places like in London, but what Gonibai and Shadar, what they've tried to do is get people from around the country to come to one place
mm-hmm.
to highlight the great achievement of the British Bangladeshi community. Whereas, like you, I will have attended many industry related events, whether it's the curry or whether it's the business.
Of course.
What I love about this is the fact that it covers all the different areas. So whether it's an educator like myself who can be in the book, or it could be somebody who works in very different, diverse industries, whether somebody's doing really well in medicine or pharmacy or an accountant.
Sports.
All these, it's one way of getting all of us in, or particularly people who are doing well across the country in the diverse sector. And for me, as somebody who's always worked in education, I do a lot of charitable work, a lot of other things where we want to engage and empower people. There is nothing more for me, nothing more inspirational than this particular book, to see other people like me. And this is what we didn't perhaps have when we were growing up, mm-hmm. the role models that we need. So when I was growing up in Leeds, there's very few people that I could look, who looked like me, who had the background of me, to actually achieve or aspire to be like them. All of a sudden now, you look at that book. So you've got younger people growing up now, and I'll mentor, you know, kids who are growing up, whether they're at school or whether they're at college. He says, look, there are people of British Bangladeshi background doing phenomenally well, mm. whether it's in business or top of the professions, whether it's accounting or whether you're looking at people in medicine. That's what's really, really inspirational about this book. So in terms of my involvement, I moved to London about 5 years ago.
One of the key things is
I've attended now last for the 5 years. And one of the things I've tried to do is encourage, and Goni Bai will know, even last year, I always try and encourage some of my friends and some of my English colleagues to come. Because I know the event, it says British Bangladeshi Who's Who, but I always sell it to people as, look, it is, yes, it's celebrating British Bangladeshi achievements, but the event itself is not just for British Bangladeshis.
No, no.
And I think it's really, really important that we have senior colleagues. They actually, like your colleague,
to witness.
I happened to bump into Howard only 2 days
ago. To witness.
Ago. Yeah, and it's like it's important that they get to see that British Bangladeshi actually,
yeah.
we're doing really, really well. Both of us working to harmless. And we often talk about deprivation. And they come, and every time our colleagues have come, they're astounded how well our community is really doing. And these are the people that can inspire the people who might not be doing particularly
thank
well.
Thank you very much for your wonderful words. Now, Fahmina. Fahmina, now, as an event manager for the venue, tell us a bit about what you do. What is your job?
So, I myself work alongside the team behind the scenes. When you call up to make inquiries, we're there. We obviously look after all cultures, nationalities, but when it's somebody from the Bengali community, there's, for me, a bit of an added buzz because it just feels like someone that's like one of my own. So to now be involved with such a prestigious event, we've got a prestigious venue to bring them both together. You know, we're hoping that it's not just a partnership for now, but it's a, you know, a long-term partnership where bringing both the, you know, the successful Bengalis together with our venue. There's a big added hype with Meridian Grand at the moment, especially on social media.
Prestigious venue, prestigious events, no-brainer.
There you go.
Absolutely, isn't it? Now, the actual event, you unfortunately wasn't there last year, were you?
I wasn't, no.
Okay, have you heard of the event? Have you heard from Nikita or anyone else?
Yeah, I've heard, you know, good things, hence why we're now working together again for the second year. I've got high expectations.
Oh, fantastic. Now, what can we expect from you as the event manager there? You know, what kind of support can we expect from you this year?
You know, it's not just like a partnership. You'll be treated like how our clients are treated as well. So we'll be there whenever you need anything. Mm-hmm. Give us a call. Mm-hmm. We'll be running around behind the scenes just to help you deliver an amazing event.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, Fahmina. Kamru.
Yes.
You were an award recipient last year.
That's correct, yes.
One of the award recipients, you know, for your business achievements, which I applaud, you know, for a young man to achieve so much. You know, it's like Mr. Alam said in the beginning that we should look up to our future generation. And you are a leading example. You know, I don't want to say too much about you in front of you, but I actually do have a lot of time for you because this young man, not only has he achieved, but he actually gives back to the community, which is absolutely fundamental for us as a community. Now, Kamru, enough of. Right. As an award recipient last year, do you feel that, you know, by receiving the award from this prestigious event from your fellow British Bangladeshi community, does that give you more, you know, drive and energy to carry on and to, make more money?
Of course it does. I mean, initially I was very thrilled to have been nominated and to winning an award was just it was a surprise, and I was very pleased to have won an award. What it has motivated me to help others even more, and particularly some of the younger generation. I feel I am inspiring some of the younger business people that are coming up, and some have actually come up and they want me to mentor them, in fact, or have lunch with them, or spend a day with me.
Absolutely.
And so I'm trying to do much as I can to help. And I've even had a few people approach me to invest in some startup businesses, which has been really amazing, and I've done that as well. So it's opened up a few more doors for me, in fact. So I've had a busy year, and it's had an impact. The winning an award does have a good impact in some very positive ways. And even my level of charity work and the community work, I've been doing more of that as well. So, yeah, I'm quite pleased with the impact and the positive feedback that I have from people. And
fantastic. Really glad to hear that.
Can I just add something you just said very briefly? This is the very reason why I think we should, you know, support a cause like the Who's Who, and there are other similar ventures people will be doing. Because what it does, it's highlighted last year, I was there obviously, come by getting this award. It highlighted there are many people who you and I might know about him, but there are many other people who won't know about
him.
So when people have read about him and heard about him, and other people, you know, will know a little bit more, and hence I think one is it's motivated other people to get to know him a little bit better, and it's allowed him to start up and help other people as
well.
But it is these hidden gems in our community I think we must highlight so that people can come forward. And
But like Shadow said, you know, there's only so much we can do.
Absolutely.
They need to come forward as well.
They need to, and the people around them. And I think this is what we need to encourage. And every year I'm encouraging other people. Okay, you might not want to be in it, but the thing is, there must be people around you who are your supporters. They must want you to go forward.
They must want you to.
It's not just you getting the accolade. For me, often it is that you're highlighting and you're potentially inspiring other people. And that's the thing. And if we don't know, if we know that we've got, you know, a very successful accountant, very successful in your field or very successful in mine, what you'll do is you'll inspire the other people. And the thing he talked about, awards. I can say firsthand, honestly, you get an award and it inspires you to. I was in this very place, I remember, almost, 10 years
ago. It reinforces you, the fact that you've worked hard for the community.
And there is that recognition, isn't there?
And motivates you to continue, doesn't it?
Absolutely, and you'll keep going more and more, and I don't know.
Can I just come to Mr. Alam? One thing that Kamru said, which I found very interesting, is that there was an opportunity for him to actually network.
I was just about to pick that point.
In that evening, you know, so you got to know other people from other backgrounds, other professions. Now, What a great platform to actually meet new people, make new friends.
If you think about the Who's, it's ninth year now, but 9 years before, perhaps people couldn't realize what it is.
Yes.
And this the time now, everybody is realizing, even without inviting, the people wanted to receive the invitation from you. So this is an encouragement, what Kamru told.
Yes.
It's a very encouraging point. He has been awarded. That is why he's more encouraged. And I'm sure that he will take his more step. He's also young there. Young people should be invited more. We are getting older doing all this.
Yeah, me and you, yes.
on that point.
We need some people who can take over our place.
Absolutely. Let me just come to Fahmina 1 second. Fahmina, last year we had around 600 people at the event. This year we know we've already have 600 people interested to attend the event. Obviously, we can't have everyone. You know, we're trying to select the appropriate people and the right people for the event. But there's a huge interest. I think if we wanted to, we could actually take it up to 1,200. If we want to, that's the interest people are showing now. You know, again, for your venue to be part of this, you know, you must feel that this is a great opportunity for you to actually promote and, you know, get involved in the Bangladeshi community.
Absolutely. I mean, I myself have been to events previously in the past where I've seen, you know, the Who's Who catalogue.
You have?
I have. So now to be involved within the programme myself, you know, already feels like an achievement, and I'm not even in there.
When are we going to have you in there then?
I don't know. I'll have to work a bit harder.
Maybe next year.
Maybe.
Definitely. Yeah. So again, yeah, it's, you know, the interest is absolutely fantastic within the community. I was at a meeting today, actually, a planning meeting, Who's Who meeting before I came here. And we've had so much interest from people, not just to attend the event, but also people nominating for awards, which shows that, you know, people are really interested. They are taking this seriously. Yeah, they want to be part of this publication. And one of the shows last year, I said, look, if you're not in this book, if you're not in this book yet, then surely, you know, you need to start working hard because you need to be part of this community. Sorry, Cambry, you were going to say
One of the This is the ninth year, and one of the key people behind all of this, I must mention, he works year in, year out, and on a daily basis, Goni Bhai. Although we don't see him on the watch him on the TV or on the live shows or whatever, but he actually works day in, day out, and I've seen him run around here and there and trying to bring people on board. And a lot of, we should be grateful that he's doing this, you know, getting this together, and it's very focused on this, and I believe that's all he does all year, actually just focus on this project. I know his son
runs the newspaper.
He also runs and I know his son Shadad is in the front as well, but I've seen him back going back 10 years trying to set this up, and he's up and down the country, in fact, just trying to get people
on
board.
I think any event, any publication, the beginning is the difficult part.
It's not easy, is it?
It's not. Absolutely.
We all do different
especially
types
in our
of
community.
Exactly.
No, it's so hard to get something off the ground, and for Goni Bhai and Shadad to take Who's Who to this level.
Yes.
And it's getting better, I believe, honestly. Yeah. It's been getting better every year.
Thanks, Farooq.
And it has, because I've been attending for the last five. I wasn't here at the beginning, but the last 5 years I've been going. It has been getting better. And one of the things you mentioned is the coverage. Because I've certainly people who are across the country. I'm from Leeds, but I have friends in Manchester, friends in Birmingham, friends in Newcastle, friends in Edinburgh. And I've been encouraging people. I've been encouraging them. And it's really, you know, all we need is a few people from them to come and see. And then it will inspire the other people. We all motivate each other without realizing you're an inspiration to somebody. You don't know who, but somebody reads your profile. And they'll be inspired by the work that you do, the work that Cam might do, work that I might do. And they're coming forward.
Yes, I just had a thought while you're talking.
Go on.
I just had a thought.
This is worrying. When
What about looking at taking Who's Who to the different parts of the country?
That would be a brilliant idea. Maybe it's a 10th year surprise. Like, you know, the England
football team. Maybe we could take Meridian Grand with us.
I was just about to make a point about that one, as he's repeated a couple of times that he was based in Leeds.
Yeah.
And you will find this year publications, maybe many people has been encouraged outside of London. So whose publication and events, not necessarily based in London now. It has been already expanded. So I hope one day, this very near, when it will be expanded all over the United Kingdom.
I've actually read profiles of people who live in Scotland.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wales.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I've had people from Birmingham come to meet me and say, look, could we have lunch with you with some business ideas and stuff. So, yes, I mean...
Who paid for the lunch?
I mean, I
anyway. Yeah, going back to you, look, you... I know you. I've known you for many, many years. He's your older brother. He's a good friend of mine.
Yeah.
And... And Kamru, as a young, you know, a business person, I find that if we have more people like Kamru, like Mr. Alam, business people in our community who have the heart to give back. I know a lot of people in our community who've made so much money, done absolutely fantastically well, you know, but they're not involved in the community. Mm-hmm. They stay away. You know, and I think that's very sad that, you know, we're losing a lot of people because they don't feel comfortable or they don't want to, for whatever reason, I don't know. But people like Kamru, you know, he's in the heart of the community and he's always giving back to the community. And that's why do you think it's important that you want to give back?
It's not just the business. I mean, Nikita mentioned earlier, it's whether it's a folk way, I believe.
Nikita's getting very famous.
Education, sports, authors, we have all the other sectors as well, community work, professional. So it's not just business people. But I mean, how do I feel I want to give something back? It's just...
You don't have to, but you do. You really do. You come forward. Yeah. You know, and I know.
I like to think I'm a generous person as well. So
you were a very generous person.
You know what?
There's a call. Let me take a call. Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi, yeah. So I was wondering, are you taking calls straight on the live TV?
We are. You're live. You are live. Hello?
Yeah. Oh, hi.
Hello?
Yes, this is a message for Fanina. I'd like to say we love you so much and you do a great job.
And you must be a relative.
No.
No? Hello? Who was that, Femina?
I don't know.
Wow! you got a fan. Fantastic. Thank you very much for your call. She called in to say Femina looks fantastic and she's lovely. Well done.
I'm saying if you read the foreword or if you go into the website of Who's Who, one of the things the reason they say they've created this particular publication is there is a general who's who was created to leave a lasting legacy. Yeah, so in, I don't know, 50 years' time, people could see who was around at this period in time, who was successful.
Yeah.
In the same way, people like Kambai, I feel, they're leaving a little bit of a legacy. Absolutely. In terms of our community, and that's really important. So you talked about these businessmen,
yeah,
who've done particularly well, and yet they're not engaged with our community.
Engaged,
well,
yeah,
what legacy are they leaving for the community?
Because absolutely.
And we are, despite everything, we are still quite close-knit community. You'll know people like this. It doesn't matter where you live in London.
We are.
But we are still connected with people across the country. And it is important that people who are successful, if you think about our forefathers, they came here with a particular agenda, in a way,
yes,
to better, not necessarily themselves, but look after their family and their kids. And we've done particularly well now. Our communities, if you look at, I mean, education, if you statistically look at, since the GCSE league tables have been brought out, do you know the British Bangladeshi? We have made the biggest increase of any community, better than the white, better than
Brilliant.
The Indian, better than the Chinese. People don't realize. So places like even where I work in Tahamlis, where you are, the people often talk about deprivation or people not particularly doing well 20 years ago, but you look where our kids are going. And
yes,
as those people become successful, I think it's really important.
Listen,
they
think,
get
I
in there.
I think what you're saying is very, very important, because 20, 25 years back, we would never have thought of, you know, we've never heard anyone saying, oh, my son, my daughter's gone to Oxford or Cambridge.
Yeah.
But now, you could hear this. Is that right, right, Nani?
Yes, you're 100% right. I was just about to say, when I came to this country in 1974, I was hardly found any place to go, even to try your own food.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And nowadays, you'll find every street, everywhere, every possible way you can get
Absolutely.
Everything.
Thank
so
you,
Mr.
Alo.
Right.
On that note, I'm going to take another short break. And please stay with us and join us after the short break, where we'll continue talking about the actual event, the date, the venue, and what to expect. See you in a moment. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to this special program of the British Bangladeshi Who's Who. My name is Zakir Khan, and we are unfortunately in the last segment of the show tonight. I am joined again now by two new members on the studio. Nikita's back on stage. Nikita, welcome back.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And I'm very pleased to say that we are now, we've finally managed to, I don't know how we've done it, but we've managed to bring on live Mr. Abdul Karim Ghani, who is the founder and editor-in-chief of the British Bangladeshi Who's Who publication. Ghani bhai, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, thank you very much.
Afne, mashallah, afne to action aske life. Afne to another na. Khub khoshto kori afne ramran lagi. Ghani bhai, thank you for coming.
Abhi to behind the scene, abhi work kori.
Absolutely, absolutely. But sometimes we need you
live. I'm not interested to come on the scene.
No, but you being here, you're inspiring us. Let me come straight to you.
Yeah, okay.
Before the break, I'm going to Allah for say about the interest, the huge interest this year. My said, Manbar then Jonogone de Heira, a publication. After I'm going to focus on in terms of my short nomination interest,
First of all, before I go answer your question, I have to thanks to Channel S, especially my friend Mahi Ferdus Jalil, who is the founder of Channel S. And his team, Taz Chaudhry,
yeah,
Ahmadu Sama Chaudhry, and finally the Farhan Masood Khan, who is look aftering us today, tonight. So all for all support, I must thank you to Channel S from the beginning,
okay,
until now, and we are hoping to future also they're supporting to us. Okay, ekhono ilogia tumoye jeta khoyra. I tomorrow point hoy logia like
interest khotan ba
nomination interest khot ruko it's a lot of interest still nomination are coming. We closed the nomination 30th of last month.
Achcha.
But I saw this morning also 5-6 nomination come
okay,
through
after
through,
the deadline
through email after
deadline
the
deadline for
it after
okay.
the deadline
yeah
and few hundred nomination comes this year.
Wow.
But we cannot put all of them because we have limitation there. So I think we can pick up shortlisted about 30, 40.
But how many new entrants do we have every year? Is it
every year 30, 40.
New ones?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. 40, 50 maximum.
Wow.
Maximum 50 we can take every year. And also,
we might end up with an encyclopedia rather than a publication.
I think he keeps it limited to
about. Also, some of them are minus from this book because we.
All right, okay.
We send the renewal form to them to renew their profile.
Okay.
Like they can edit their profile, they can send new profile and pictures. But who is not responds? Who is not interested to stay?
Right. Okay.
We can remove them. So that's how it's worked. And.
So, you know, before the break, I also spoke about the not just the people who want to be in the publication, but also people who want to attend the event on the night. Mm. I know we can only take up to a maximum 600, I think, max.
Yeah.
But you get much more interest in that, don't you, in terms of...
Yes. A lot of inquiry comes, like inquiry start coming from now on. Mm. So we can't accommodate all of them because... how we invite is there is a 270 profile on this book, so we have to invite them first. This is their this is the first priority.
Okay. That makes sense.
So yes. so 270 is twice how many comes? Mm-hmm. It comes nearly 500.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yes.
More than 500.
More than 500.
But on that day. Everyone is not attending.
But you've got dignitaries. VIPs.
Plus the dignitary VIPs, guests we invite from outside, and also media personalities we invite. So we can, our limitation is 550, say. Amra 550 এর মধ্যে আমরা রাখতাম চাইয়াকে এর বেশ আমরা করতাম পারি না আর বুকের বারা আউটসাইড অফ বুক আমরা বেশি ইনভাইট করতাম পারি না যার কারণে হইল গিয়ারি অনেক আমরা ফ্রেন্ড আসুন ফ্রেন্ড সার্কুল বা হু ইজ নো আস দে আর দে সেড ও আই এম নট ইন দ্য বুক আই এম নট ইন দ্য ইভেন্ট সো আই আস্ক দেম হোয়াই ডোন্ট ইউ নমিনেট ইউর সেলফ অর ইউ ক্যান টেল সাম ওয়ান টু নমিনেট ইউ Without nomination, I can take from the Brick Lane or from the Empire State. Empire State, yeah.
Thank you, Gunibai. I mean, after I have to interrupt you. Dear viewers, just Gunibai, I'm going to ask TV to look at very well spoken. We have a small footage, a very small footage to show you. I think it's very just a simple glance of last year's event, I think. So please, when you're ready, let's see the footage.
Thing to celebrate success wherever that success comes. This is a community that is disproportionately successful, contributes hugely not only to London but to the whole UK.
Publishing the British Bangladeshi Who is Who for the last 8 years.
So it's very important for young people to get involved in this kind of organization, to attend this organization as well, basically.
Absolutely. I mean, the guests are arriving, we're having canapes, there's beautiful music playing, and it feels really good to be here.
Human Bangladesh Airlines, Who's Who J Boita publication hoy, Sheta Amra, on board in the Abong on board Amra Boita, passenger take a South Korea.
To be here this evening in this wonderful venue. I have never been here before. I'm absolutely knocked out. I think it's a fantastic place to hold this particular occasion. So well done.
Wow, Nikita, how did that look?
You know what? Sometimes you're in the venue every day and you don't appreciate, you know, the glamour and the beauty. And I just think a big round of applause to the entire Who's Who team for creating such a fantastically stunning event. I just think it was such a success.
You didn't recognise your own venue, did you?
Well, the chandeliers are a bit of a giveaway.
Now, one of the things I actually forgot to mention, that and the Biman manager did, is that we actually managed to get the Who's Who publication, this publication, in the actual aircraft, in the Biman, in the business class lounge. Business class.
Yes.
So, what do you think, Farouk?
That's great. I think it happened a few years ago.
Something that
I know Goni Bhai has been working on for a little while. And it's not just the Biman that are recognizing. Having something like this helps, you know, if you work in the mainstream, whether people are working in education or health, they sometimes want to know more about our communities. Mm. What this does is highlights people in these, you know, particular sectors. And it's a reference point. So I don't know whether you managed to get it in Parliament and a few other people. And
in a lot of organization, as far as I know, is if I go to any event, I can see maximum of guests there from this book. Mm. Any event, if you go, any event in here in UK. Yeah. So the book is book helping to the community. Like Biman Bangladesh Airlines, Bangladesh High Commission, lots of voluntary organization, which is keep this book and they use it for the event.
But don't you also this publication also sent to many government?
Yeah, I'm coming to this. Yeah. Mm. We sent this publication to the Parliament House. It's few MPs, like 50, 60 MPs we can invite. So we send everyone to one of the book. Libraries, more than 100 libraries in London.
Wow.
And outside London is Birmingham, Manchester, Cambridge, Oxford. There is a lot of library in my list. I can we can post this. Also in Bangladesh, there is a TV channels office, libraries in Dhaka, libraries in Sylhet region. Mm-hmm. So a lot of places. Last year I took about 200 of books to Bangladesh.
200?
200 I distributed to Bangladesh. Bangladesh, Dhaka yeah. 100 and 100 for Sylhet.
Okay.
You know something, I was in Bangladesh earlier in the year and I was sat somewhere.
And No,
I'm not making this up. There's a whole group of us, we'd gone there, and we just sat there and I saw this book. And what it made you realize is like, you realize that more and more of us are doing, especially the charitable work. There's more and more of us are going back, whether it's our businesses, whether it's charities, are we doing? The people in Bangladesh, this is what I was really surprised about.
Yeah.
People in Bangladesh are quite interested to know who in the UK is doing what and who's doing particularly well. Because you know there is a habit that some people can go from here and big themselves up in Bangladesh.
Whereas no, really.
This is almost like authenticating. You know, if you're saying like Zakir Khan, you're doing very well with Canary Wharf Group, you're doing this and the other. Yeah. This kind of authenticating, you understand? So I'm not making this up. This is a
true story. I believe you.
And also website, which is now we developed the website is... video footage, everything there. Mm-hmm.
Last the footage we just saw.
Yeah.
Those footage.
Yeah, everything there. Last year, full event we put on the website and also the YouTube.
Also, channelers showed the program, didn't they?
Yeah.
Yes.
And the publication is from 2008 to until 2015 edition is there. So. Lots of inquiry comes from all over the world.
Wow.
Where the Bangladeshi are living, thara inquiry koroin, email inquiry koroin, kono shomoy sometimes phone, we can receive phone, tara koin je eta kita dinishta kita event kita ila kila kora hoy ta amra Bangladesh kortam parmuni.
I think they followed this in America as well. There's a couple of awards they're doing very similar to this.
Yeah, amra America kortam parmuni.
Jackie Boy ekta age he had a bright idea. I think I've just got one now. Let's go all over Europe. Take it around Europe, take it around the world.
Yeah. So, I'm going to come to Cumbria. Yeah.
So, it's different way. Online, just now, because of the technology, is anybody can see from anywhere, and they can search, they can find anybody's profile.
After interrupt, we'll let her call really.
Okay.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum salam.
জি ভাই আমার নাম মোহাম্মদ কুদুস আমি ব্রিস্টল থেকে মাতলাম
ব্রিস্টল থেকে আসসালামু আলাইকুম ভাই এবার শুননি
আলহামদুলিল্লাহ ভাই আলহামদুলিল্লাহ আমি আপনাদের লাস্ট 2015 এর বুক আসলাম
জি
এন্ড আমি আপনারা অপরচুনিটি পাইছি যে বনিপাইরে টিভি দেখিয়া যে তাহলে থ্যাংক ইউ জানাইতাম যে তানি কারণে আমি আমরা কমিউনিটি এখন বাকা আমারে সবে সিনরা আমি বিশ্বন থাকায় আমি কমিউনিটির লোকে টাচও আসলাম না
সো
বিকজ অফ দ্য হুজ হু 2015 আমি এখন বলতে আমার কমিউনিটির মানুষের সিনরা আর এগুলাকে আমি সম্পূর্ণ ক্রেডিট দিতাম চাই আমার মানি বাইরে আর ইনশাল্লাহ আমি দিস ইয়ার ইভেন্ট আইমো ইনশাল্লাহ অ্যান্ড থ্যাংক ইউ আপনারেও আপনি খুব টিমর লগে আপনিও পুরা 100% দিরা অ্যান্ড ইয়া ইনশাল্লাহ সি ইউ 17
থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ মাই ব্রাদার আব্দুল কুদ্দুস ফ্রম অল দ্য ওয়ে ফ্রম ব্রিস্টল উই হ্যাভ অ্যানাদার কল হ্যালো আসসালামু আলাইকুম
আসসালামু আলাইকুম
Walaikum Salaam.
Yeah, my name is Shaukat and I'm ringing from Manchester.
From Manchester, Brother Shaukat, how are you?
Alhamdulillah. And yourself?
Alhamdulillah, Brother. What is your opinion on this program and this publication?
Well, I can see the whose purpose is to inspire the Bengali community to move forward. But I would like to ask you a question.
Yep.
Isn't it better to focus the individuals who be prominent figures in Who's Who as a role model rather than a success? Because success seems to be it's like, oh, look what I've achieved. I got big cars, the suits I'm wearing, the houses I'm living in. And if it's more of a role model, then people will think, right, this guy has come from a working class background from disadvantaged situation and broke through that and made bettered himself and his family. So
that's a good point. It's a good point. I think Farooq.
I'll just say something on this. I think it's going to be very difficult to create a publication of role models.
Right.
Because who my role model might be very different to yours or somebody else out there. What this book highlights is the people who, in I almost feel everybody's term, who've been very successful at what they do. So if you reach the top of your profession.
But like the brother said, I just want to add to what he said. Many people in this book have started from humble beginnings.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. You know, so the point. I think practically everybody has come from quite humble beginnings.
Yeah.
The role model thing is up to us to see who is our role model. So as you go through, as you come to the event, one of the beauties of this event is a networking opportunity unlike any other that I can think of in the British Bangladeshi events calendar. Mm-hmm. There are many events you and I go to.
Yeah.
I can't think of another one where you get such a cross-section and diversity of our community. We often talk about diversity in the ethnic sense, in terms of our work. But in this sense, it's people coming from Scotland, coming from the north.
Can I just take another call?
Of course.
Sorry. You can. Yeah. Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum salam.
Yes, brother. Where are you calling from?
My name is Ibrahim Rahman. I'm calling from Cambridge.
From Cambridge. Brother Ibrahim, how are you?
Yes, I'm very well, thank you. How is everyone on the panel?
MashaAllah, we're very good, brother. Thank you. We're even better than that you called in.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a few smiling faces there, particularly Johnny Sussell, because I did work with him last year on the last year's publication. I was one of the contributors there. So I just wanted to mention about how I enjoyed the experience working with him and helping out behind the scenes there, and also particularly sort of powering social media presence behind the Who's Who. Because I did a lot of the tweeting and.
Okay. Are we?
See how we put that across in the event there.
Will you be there this year?
No, inshallah, I hope so. Hopefully, I'll get a ticket. what's going on? But like I said, last year's event was a fantastic occasion.
I
really enjoyed it.
I'll invite you now.
Ibrahim, he's inviting you now, live on air.
I invite you now, okay, on air.
Okay, thank you very much. Nikita, I just want to say to you, the first caller who called in actually said, he called from Bristol, and he said, look, before the Who's Who publication, he wasn't very much known in the community. He's a businessman from Bristol.
Yeah. Yeah.
But last year he had his entry here, and he said it made change his life. You know, people in Bristol got to know who he is, and he's made so many new friends, business people, and he just thinks it's an amazing opportunity.
Well, I think it's a fantastic opportunity. And one of the things that really inspires me about the British Bangladeshi community, I have the pleasure to meet a lot of young British Bangladeshis and British Bangladeshi families. Obviously, they come to the venue, they view it for the weddings. And over the process of the wedding planning experience, obviously, you get to know these families. And the amount that they give back to their families, whilst at the same time maintaining often professional jobs, jobs in media, jobs in accountancy, you can just see that there is a real passion for holding together the community. And I think the event itself underpins that passion. And that's why I love hosting the event so much. I feel humbled to be part of it. And I'm inspired by, you know, as the caller said before, the role models. You know, this isn't just about success. This is about creating inspiration for future generations. And I've just got to wholeheartedly applaud what the whole BB team, BB Who's Who team have done.
Thank you very much.
You know, just quickly to add, you know the role models we talk about. Mm-hmm. How often do you actually get that opportunity to be around these very role models you talk about? So whether you're talking about our politicians,
absolutely,
who've done things that nobody else has done, or some of our most successful business people, or the other professions, if one night you can mingle with the stars, if they are the stars.
Just going
I'm sure all the people are coming to meet you are now come by.
Just going back to the first caller, what he was saying, the impact. He's had an impact on his life,
impact,
in his community, and the networking has come together for him, and he seemed very pleased and that he feels successful and a role model for his local community there as well. And the second caller was also raising the issue about role models. And I feel recently like I'm a role model for some of the younger, and I hope that inspired some of these youngsters to, and I'm trying to give them time to say, look, do this, do that, and I'm also investing with some of them in various small businesses, startup businesses.
Wow.
So it's it does. We do see ourselves as, you know, some kind of role model, as well as the book gives impact to people who win awards or simply been in the publication itself.
Thank you very much. Gunibai, we're actually running out of time. So I think it's just too late.
Event যেগুলো হয় আদার্স ইভেন্ট হয় এটা হলো আমরা এটা হলো একাডেমিক ইভেন্ট বাট একাডেমিক ইভেন্ট ইজ ভেরি হার্ড টু মেক ইট হ্যাপেন ওকে এটা করতে গিয়ে অনেক হার্ড হার্ড অনেক হার্ড অনেক হার্ড বিকজ অফ আমি এটা করতাম পারলাম লাইক ইয়োর সেলফ অল অফ আস ইজ সাপোর্টিং মি স্পেশালি মেডিয়ান গ্রান্ড চ্যানেল এস ফ্রম দ্য বিগিনিং চ্যানেল এসে তারা সাপোর্ট করায় মেডিয়ান গ্রান্টে রিসেন্টলি সাপোর্ট করা সো লাইক দোজ কাইন্ড অফ অর্গানাইজেশন কানেরওয়ার্ফ গ্রুপ এরকম অর্গানাইজেশনে সাপোর্ট থাকায় এবং ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল অলসো উই হ্যাভ লট অফ ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল হু ইজ not coming on the talk show, but they are helping me
behind
the scene. They are helping me, so all their help is make it success. Are financially oilogiari academic venture to, that's why is people are not interesting to sponsor this this event, because if it's a business venture, then people can finance you. But there are interest home kano oilogia. That's why I community whole community amra Bangladeshi British Bangladeshi community ami hoitam sai mohota je itar jodi legacy rakhta sai amra jodi itar continue kortam sai the everyone have to come forward and support us on every year every event.
Thank you for your last words.
I think Gonibai has been doing a fantastic job wholeheartedly behind the Who's Who venture. I do think that it does create role models, but inspires people like Kambai winning an award last year. Look at the, you know, how it's opened things up for him. We had the chap who called from Bristol, how it's changed for him. And for me, it's like, you know, I'm an academic, I'm an educator. All my life is around engaging and empowering people. And every year, Gonibai knows, I take lots of people, as much as possible, to go and see the success of our community, and hopefully they inspire others to do better than what we're doing.
Thank you very much. Kamri, your last words, please.
This has inspired me personally. I have a small awards every year. Farukbay came to our last one. It's for the children doing well in their GCSE 7+, 11+.
Okay.
And I see the happiness and the encouragement they get from all of this, and they try and do better in the next. So I hope, in a wider context, you know, people take things in their own way and benefit from it in a positive way. I certainly have.
Thank you, Nikita. You're.
Meridian Grand is so excited to partner with BB Who's Who, and we're just looking forward to the excitement, the pizzazz that is surrounding the event. And it's such a worthwhile event. If you haven't been, I suggest you follow on social media, come to the event if you can come to the event, because really BB Who's Who and Meridian Grand are so happy that there is this celebration in the British Bangladesh.
Thank you very much, Nikita. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for your wonderful time and presence. Dear viewers, we have actually run out of time. What I would say to you, you know, a big thank you to Channel S, a big thank you to all the sponsors, all the supporters, to Nikita, to Meridian Grand, to Kamru, to Farooq, you know, for supporting this wonderful event. If not anything else, ladies and gentlemen, I think we found a new presenter, Nikita. So until next time, assalamu alaikum.